So in our previous video, we showed how to convert from our initial quadcopter landing legs to this design space for topology optimization on the left of the screen. In this video, we'll show how to apply a series of load cases to this design space in order to output an optimized geometry, all within Ansys Discovery. So let's do it. So here we have our same geometry from the previous video. And so far we've just been working in the model tab, but now we want to go to the explore tab, which is going to use GPU solvers to do quick solves and is really useful for topology optimization. So we want to do a static structural analysis, and then we want to add a topology optimization on top of that. So first, let's start inputting some forces. So I want to put a force, and I want to input that force to each of these bottom four legs. So I'm gonna just hold control and select them. And there's a couple of ways we can input the force, but in this case, I want to input components in the X, Y, and Z directions. So here I want to just put the largest component in the Z direction, the direction where the quadcopter will be landing, so a positive force in the Z to simulate the landing. But I also want to include some off-axis forces in both the X and Y directions that will be varying later when we set our load cases. But for now, we'll set them to be 50 newtons each. And while we're here, we want to add these as a parameter. So we're going to add that as a parameter. And we have that in our model. We can see that this distributed force here is under the static structural branch. So the next thing I want to do is to add a moment. So I'm going to just select these same four legs and apply a moment. And I want to use the global coordinate system. In this case, I just want to apply the moment about the z-axis. So let's apply a 40 newton moment about the z-axis to each of these legs. And we can see we now have this moment in our structural branch. Now I want to keep add a fixed support. So where this geometry is going to meet the housing geometry, I have imprinted the locations where the previous legs attached to the housing geometry. And we want to keep these attachment locations. So I'm simply going to apply a fixed support to each of these four legs. So we can do that. And we now see we have our fixed support here. So we should have enough to run a structural analysis, but we see here we have a notification. So this notification, so it is calling out that we have the fixed support is on the same surface as the bonded contact, but really we shouldn't have any bonded contacts because we just have one part. So if we look in our analysis on the left side here is going to show whether the parts are active for simulation. So right now, actually all of our parts are active for simulation. So what I want to do is right click on the part that we want to and simulate on this part only. So now we can see that bonded contact is no longer existing and our message has gone away. So now we want to add a topology optimization because we don't just want to do this load case and see the result one time. We want to do a series of optimizing to get our desired geometry. So we have here, now we can see we have added, once we add the topology optimization, we can see that We have a protected depth for this one. I'm gonna keep it as 1 centimeter. So we can see that the red lines here are representing how much protected depth. So if I wanted to really keep a lot, I could reduce this to 0.1, and maybe that's kind of unrealistic. But I do want to keep 10 millimeters. So the other parameter we have here is the optimization percent. So let's edit this one and have a look. So within the topology optimization, we can optimize for multiple different items. We can maximize the stiffness, the natural frequency, and a series of other options that are available. In this case, we'll use the maximized stiffness. And we can also choose the percent that we want to reduce the volume by. In this case, we're going to parameterize that percent to get a couple of different optimized bodies. And we can also, if we wanted to, we could add some manufacturing constraints, which are going to be applicable to depending on the manufacturing process that you'd be using. So as I mentioned, we're going to add this optimization percent as a parameter. And then we'll also add the moment as a parameter. Now we're going to come into our design space here and have a look at our parameters. So one thing I noticed is, yeah, that this force, how I've added it, it's just the magnitude. So what I want to do actually is remove this as a parameter. And then we're going to edit it. And then from within this force components, I'm going to parameterize one of the components. And now we can see that each of the force components, the X, Y, and Z, are parameters in our model. So next, we're going to come into the test cases tab in order to vary the out-of-plane forces and moment in order to give us a symmetric design. So if I enter the test cases tab, I can either individually add test cases, or I can use this generate test cases button to automatically create a series of test cases. So that's what I'm going to do in this case. And so I've already preloaded in here some of the test cases. So I'm going to vary the moment to be between positive and negative 40. And I'm going to vary the distributed force of in the X and Y direction between 50 and minus 50. So I've also set the number of iterations for each to 2. Actually, in this one, I've set it to 3 by accident. So I'm going to update that to 2. And we can see that because we have 3 variables that we have with 2 variations, we have 2 to the 3rd, so we have a total of 8 test cases. So if I click here on this Create 8 Test Cases button, it's going to automatically create these 8 test cases where the Z force is constant, but the moment and the X and Y forces are being varied between positive and negative. So once we have our test cases set, we can come into the variations tab where we'll change the optimization percent. So we could similarly define a series of variations, but for this one, I'm just going to do 3 simple cases. So I'm just going to add a few different optimization items. So in this case, optimizing to around 90%, removing 90% of the material is going to get us right back to around the same mass, the 2.4 kgs as before. So I'm going to just simply vary between 90 and 94 percent. So I'm just going to fill in these three boxes, and we can rename these DV90. '92 and '94, and we can just go ahead now that we have these test cases set up, our test cases set up, so we can see that for each of these we're doing the load case, all of the test cases. So I'm just going to come here and update all of our variations, and it's going to immediately start reducing material in order to do the topology optimization. So the first time it will remove 90%, then 92, then 94. So you can see already it's starting to remove some material. So while that goes, I've already prepared a model where I've solved all three cases. So we can have a quick look at that. So here we can see in this table the total mass remaining after the variation. So in the 90% case, we have around 3 kgs and reducing all the way to 1.74 kgs. So displayed on the screen here is the 94% removal case. And we can just quickly create a quick scatter plot. So in this case, we'll put the mass on the x-axis, and on the y-axis we'll put the von Mises stress. And we can see that as we continue to remove more material, the maximum von Mises stress is increasing. And then finally we can post-process and review our results. So now we're showing the displacement. But if I want to, I can update this and switch to the von Mises stress. So here we have our optimized shape. And next time we will work on converting this optimized shape into a solid geometry. So thanks for watching. See you in the next one.